So this is a cloning ball about, well, earlier this spring, about 4 months ago. We put this ball around this branch and it quickly started putting out roots. Can you see those roots right there? We stuffed the ball full of peat moss. We cut a ring, about a centimeter ring around the branch, packed the peat moss around, put the cloning ball around, and waited for the roots to come out. Now that the roots are out, we can now cut this branch off. Here we're gonna cut this branch right here. Now, we've got this branch. Let me see, Titus.
And we are.
We really wanna see these roots. You see how these roots have filled this cloning ball? That's a better shot. We cut the branch off. Now you wanna take that cloning ball off?
Okay.
Okay, now open it up.
Gently, real gently, because those roots are in
there. How did that happen?
Oh my, inside the ball.
A fig tree is growing.
A new baby fig tree. Okay, now pull those roots off. No, no, have mommy do it. There we go.
Yeah.
So that is ready to plant.
How did that happen? No, I wanna know how that happened.
Well, this ring that we put a scar in the branch. I wonder if you can even see it.
I can see it.
Where we cut the bark off. And right there where we cut the bark off is right where it started to root out. So let's dig a hole. Yeah, we're gonna bury this. Right. Go ahead and bury the leaves. You can leave them out just a little bit. Now wind is gonna push this over. We should stake this up.
Why haven't the reef go through the red?
Why don't you go give me some bamboo? Let's stake this. Here, after we pulled all the leaves off but two, we're starting to have a new shoot come through here. Where are the new leaves?
I'll show you.
That's a new leaf.
That's a new leaf.
They're struggling though. You can see this new leaf came out and it's a little crispy.
But this one isn't.
These are good and these are good. We got water in here?
Then look at this.
You better put some water in there.
See this leaf? And this leaf? And this leaf? And this leaf?
It's really budding out. And 2 months later, it looked like this. And 2 years ago, we cloned its mother in this arrow cloner that this NASA scientist guy dropped off for us to check out. Super cool. All without hormones. All right, here we've got some fig trees that we've propagated. We've took some cuttings, cut them at a 45 degree angle, and rooted them out. Now we are ready to turn one fig tree into four or five. We're going to spread out the roots and plant them right down into this pot. And before that, we were doing it with tomatoes. We've taken some clippings from the garden of our tomato plants and we've tried to root them in here. No hormones, no nothing. And here they are, they're rooting on their own, ready to be put right in the aquaponics system. Here's a couple with roots. We're just gonna push some rocks aside and plant them up. And still another way to clone is to just take a cutting, especially of blackberries, and just put it right in the barrel ponics. So here's the blackberries a couple weeks later after we stuck them in the barrel ponics and they've started to root. We've just clipped it off the branch there and it's already putting out a good root. And with strawberries, all you got to do is put out a bucket. They'll jump right in your bucket. Right when they jump, you got to pin them down. More buckets, more strawberries. These guys have jumped one, two, three times.
All these strawberries.
Hey, if you like these videos, like and subscribe down below. That goes a long way. If you want to see more videos, head over to Patreon. We are releasing a ton more content over there. If you want to see more, consider supporting our video efforts over at patreon.com/theurbanfarmingguys. The more support we raise, the more videos we can make. We also have exclusive content over there for our supporters. If you want to get involved, take a class, do an internship, or if you want to come volunteer with us, go to theurbanfarmingguys.com, the website. Or maybe you want to come and teach a skill at the makerspace. You can make some money doing that. You can teach a welding class, teach a sewing class, CNC router, CNC laser. There are a lot of ways you can get involved. Come serve as a mentor on the robotics team for a season, or you could donate tools. We have a whole list of needs on the website. You can sponsor a project that needs funding, projects in various phases that need your help. You could come to Kansas City and manage a project here. Short term, long term, you could join the makerspace and start inventing, start building out your ideas, start your business. We have studio space and co-working space as well. Go to theurbanfarmingguys.com to see a list of our needs and all the ways you can get involved. And thanks to all of you already involved, you guys are making it happen. Together, we are helping disadvantaged communities rebuild from within. See you next video.